If you and your teams need clarity on warranty information and reminders about contracts, InvGate Insight is here to help. Hi, Matt Barron, product specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Insight, you can input warranty information for individual assets along with their support details and many other aspects of your contracts. Before we get started, you can always grab a trial instance of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along, and you'll find a link in the description below. Warranties are a great tool to extend the life of an IT asset. This video will show you how to leverage that expiration data to automate and alert teams to take action. Capturing the warranty information is done at the point of purchase. This is for lots of reasons, but the most obvious one is that teams typically buy a batch of laptops at the same time that also share a similar warranty expiration. We can also pull in warranty information for Dell and Lenovo machines automatically, and we continue to add vendors to that list that we integrate with automatically. These integrations can be found under Settings, Integrations, Warranty API settings. No matter how you collect warranty information, all your assets basically have a warranty expiration date that needs to be entered and tracked. And to stay on top of that, there are a couple of spots where you can incorporate this into your processes. The first one that gets missed the most often is when assets are undergoing repair. This is an important time to reflect on the warranty expiration to determine if we should act on it and either replace the device or have the vendor manage the repair. So when our agent gets a ticket to repair a laptop like this one where the laptop is no longer functioning, they can make the repairs and they can go to the specific device, in this case Nancy's computer notebook 14. I can actually just click on this device, see some specific details about the hardware and software installed on the device, but click here as well to see the individual asset in Insight. I'm going to go to the Financials tab here, which shows me the warranty expiration. It looks like it expired last May. So I would actually, at this point, as a desk-side analyst, need to determine, am I going to be performing these repairs or are we sending it out for warranty repair? In any case, I'm going to follow our standard operating procedure to check the warranty information before moving forward with the repair. The second way to track warranty lifecycle on your assets is to simply report on them. This would be used for teams if they repurchase coverage to extend the warranty, or this same visualization technique applies to contracts to determine the next course of action. Does a contract need to be renewed, extended, or can we just let it expire? For this, I've used our customizable dashboards in InvGate Insight. I've created one here called Assets That Require Attention, and on it, I've got my upcoming contracts that are expiring. So here's my contracts by expiration date and provider, so I can actually look at my calendar, see that February is coming, and I can see which contracts I need to review. I've got one with CDW and one with Cloudflare. Both of these contracts need to be reviewed. And I can click on these and actually navigate to the individual certificates and contracts and see the details there. Over here, I've got warranties specifically. So this is another parameter you can measure on and report on. Maybe I want to see which assets have an expiring warranty and have an open ticket. I can actually just see specifically I've got 8 machines whose warranty are up in February, 54 of them are up in January, and I can see the specific individual assets here. Now, I can actually report on this using our text field as well. So I can say warranty, and I can say warranty is expired, and it's going to show me all the assets where my warranty has been expired. I can also add additional filters here, so show me ones with tickets that are open. We'll just say is greater than 0, and the warranty is expired. Now this is my hot list. Any of these specific devices come in for a ticket or to get repaired, these are the devices that I'm going to get replaced out. So for instance, this asset 003, if that hits my desk, I know that the warranty is expired and I can take action. The last bit I need to show you is the automation to email yourself when warranties and contracts are expiring. Under Settings, Assets, and Automations, I've got this contract renewal notification already set up. And so I can show you Specifically, this is going to repeat every day, and it's going to show me contracts whose expiration date is exactly 30 days out, and also contracts where the expiration is exactly 60 days out. And then this is sending an email to me so that I've got 60 and 30 days to act on those warranties. Now, I'll get an email for every expiring contract and warranty as a reminder to take action. And this is just one aspect of InvGate Insight that's designed to make managing the chaos of assets easier and less intense. For more on this topic, subscribe to our YouTube channel or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.